don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Hey guys, welcome back to Sahara Football. So after that amazingly excruciating victory over Niger that secured qualification for the Ghana Black Satellite into the AFCON Under 20, which will be taking place in Mauritania. They took to their dressing rooms, took to their dinner for, and they went to celebrate deep into the night. We're looking at some of the videos of the celebration, but Ghana have found out their opponent, and it is going to be Burkina Faso. I'll be uploading that video later. Burkina Faso is the team Ghana will be facing in the final on Sunday, and it will be interesting to see how things go, because Burkina Faso, in their last game that they just played with Ivory Coast, they beat them 4-0. Yeah, Burkina Faso beat Ivory Coast 4-0. Now, the last time Ghana qualified for the Africa Youth Championship was in 2015. The Nigerian goalkeeper kept his team in the game as he saved Mugi's Zakaria's strike after he has been put through by Emmanuel Essien, before acrobatically pushing a tenacious effort from Sule Mohammed over the post. Now, the save from the latter forced an injury to the goalkeeper, who was later replaced. The Precious Boa forced substitute goalkeeper Omar Lawali to make a save in the 39th minute with a powerful left-footed free kick. Now, Precious Boa again came close in the second half in the 56th minute, but his free kick rattled the crossbar to the relief of the Nigerians. The Black Satellites later had a goal ruled out for offside. In my opinion, that was a wrong decision. Coach Karim Zito brought on goalkeeper Emmanuel Esu for Danlad Ibrahim. Quite a decision I didn't get initially, but the game remained level at that point until 120 minutes before Ghana, looking the hungrier of the two sides, carried the day after Niger, the first kicker of the penalty, missed it. Techiman 11 Wonders midfielder Abdul Mugi Zakaria had a very busy afternoon, dictating play and pushing the opponents into their half in search of space, but none of their efforts translated into goals as referee called for a penalty shootout. Emmanuel Esso, Abdul Mugi Zakaria, Precious Boa, Suleimana Mohammed, and Frank Watting, who converted the final kick, helped Ghana into the finals and qualification to the AFCON Under 20. We all know Ghana's issues with penalties, so it was a relief. It was great to see that the Black Satellites put the woes Ghana has from penalty shootout to rest in this tournament. I was quite worried, didn't want the game to get into penalties, but it got there and they successfully sailed through. That's the most important thing. It was a great game of football. Ghana should have won it in extra time, in my opinion. That ball was not offside. Great to see Ghana versus Burkina Faso on Sunday. I'll leave you with celebrations of the boys deep into the night. They will be having a long rest, much deserved rest. I have to admit, they deserve it thoroughly. They have worked really, really hard and to get to this point, and I'm really excited and happy for them. So the Ghana Black Satellites will be facing Burkina Faso on Sunday. Your predictions in the comments box. Let me know, who do you think will carry the WAFU Zone B Under 20 cap? Subscribe if you haven't. Click on the notification bell. So I'll see you guys in the next one. The Black Satellites have done Ghana proud, are through into the final of the WAFU Zone B Cup Under 20.
that's Oshagake, Oshagake.